Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Chapter 7, Circular Motion and Gravitation. In this video, I'm going to be preparing you for Practice A. In order to do that, I need to give you a little bit of a background for circular motion. Up to this point, our motion analysis have been one-dimensional and two-dimensional, but in a straight line, at least in the X or Y or both components. Instead, we're going to be going circular. And round. So I've got a pen here pointing straight up at you. And if I could spin it around perfectly round, the axis of rotation is right in the middle, okay, where it's going around. So this is a handout that I posted in Google Classroom. It's a two-sided summary for chapter 7. Okay, so we're going to be talking about just the first half of the page here for practice A and practice B. Okay, so big lesson is, what is tangential velocity? I'll show you a picture of that. I also want you guys to start learning the terms period and frequency. So I was writing down an example for you guys. Let's say we were in the classroom upstairs and we had one person in our class run out the hallway and run around the whole perimeter of the second floor. So they went down past Mr. Lovelace's room and then past Miss Mamola's room, and then up the other direction past the little library and then back into the classroom. How long it took to go all the way around one revolution is the period. All right, so let's say it took one of our students to go around 10 seconds, took them 10 seconds. So we say the period is 10 seconds. So, you know, 10 seconds into 1 minute is 6 times. So we could say the frequency is 6 times per 1 minute. 6 times per 1 minute. That's what the frequency is. And you're going to find out that the period and the frequency are reciprocals of one another. Okay. So if the period was 10 seconds, the frequency would be 1 over 10, 0.1. What does that mean? 0.1 seconds. Well, if we did 6 times in 1 minute and we convert that to seconds, we'd say 0.1 seconds. And that's the frequency. So that means that it took you a tenth of a second. A tenth was the frequency. All right, we'll give you more examples on that later for homework. Okay, so we have angular velocity. How fast did it, how many revolutions per time? That's angular velocity. Okay, so this is where you actually learn about radians. We're not gonna be doing too much in that in this class though, but a radian, 2π is 1 radian. How many times all the way around one? Okay. So here's the one I want to draw your attention to, centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration. That's my highlighter. Centripetal acceleration. So acceleration is changing because the direction is changing, not the magnitude necessarily. So acceleration, remember, is a vector. And what you're going to learn is the equation. So centripetal acceleration is tangential velocity squared divided by the radius. What is tangential velocity? Okay, I gave you guys another handout called tangential velocity and centripetal acceleration. It's a sort of a little proof of the direction of centripetal acceleration going to the center. So looking at this direction, at this circle here, I have an object that's going around the circle. It's going around and round and round and round. At any point, the velocity is the tangent. Remember from geometry, the tangent means a straight line that touches a circle at one point, okay? So at this point, there is my velocity, V1. It's going in this direction. And at this point, there is my V2. It's tangent. The line is tangent. The vector is tangent to the circle. And then at this point, it's pointing down. What I mean by it, the velocity. Velocity is pointing down. At this point, the velocity is pointing, what's that, southwest, let's say. And at this point, it's kind of pointing to the left. Maybe at the very, very bottom, would be pointing exactly west. All right, so notice that at every point on the circle, the velocity vector is a tangent to the circle, right? So that's what's meant by tangential velocity. What's the velocity going around? The direction is going to be changing. The magnitude of the acceleration, though, here we go. You remember that acceleration is change in velocity over time, okay? So V final minus V initial over time. That's still true, but in centripetal acceleration, the math works out having to do with the radius of the circle, So you're going to want to know what the radius is. The bigger the radius or the smaller the radius, you're going to have a difference in your tangential acceleration as well as tangential velocity. All right, so I'm sorry, centripetal acceleration. So the magnitude of centripetal acceleration is the tangential velocity squared divided by the radius, okay? So that's the definition of centripetal acceleration, velocity squared radius. Now, you notice that the velocity is going out tangential to the circle, but it turns out that the centripetal acceleration is always pointing to the center. Always point to the center. And that's what the word centripetal actually means. It's seeking the center. It's going towards the center. And by the way, when you watch the crash course, the British, we Americans pronounce it centripetal and she pronounces it centripetal. But we don't. But when you hear centripetal, it's centripetal to us. All right, so I put here a small little proof to you. Why is it that the vector of centripetal acceleration is pointing to the center? How come? So it's in the radius, but it's pointing to the center. So just like you learned here, acceleration is the change in velocity over time. Remember, velocity is a vector, acceleration is a vector, but time is just a scalar. So whatever the direction of the change in velocity is, that's the direction of the centripetal acceleration. So let's take a look here. In this circle, the first point we have is point A. And you notice that the tangential velocity is going straight out. Let's call that east, straight out east. Okay, if I turn my circle, straight out east. And then the second place, point B, it's tangential to the circle and it's going out to the right. So remember that the change is V final minus V initial. So we're gonna say V2 minus V1. Well, remember when we add vectors, subtracting vectors is similar. We just take the inverse of the second one, okay? So I should write that down here. We want to do V2 minus V1. Well, that's the same thing as V2 plus the opposite direction of V1. So we're actually adding vectors. All right, so here's my V2. Notice how it's in the same direction, kind of blown up a little bit. In the same direction, there's my V2, and I want to add it to the inverse of V1. So the inverse of V1 is going to the left instead of to the right. So from here, I'm going to take this point, I'm going to go to the left. Now I just add it. And when I add it, it's going to go directly to the center. So you can try it for yourself on your paper here. Draw exactly the same distance, same magnitude from here in here, and you'll find that the change in velocity is exactly here pointing to the center, okay? And that's why your centripetal acceleration is always pointing to the center. So in this last one, you'll see two different points on this circle where there's motion going round and round. And in both cases, centripetal acceleration is pointing to the center, okay? So there's my explanation to you on that, but you do need to know that the magnitude of the centripetal acceleration is the tangential velocity squared divided by r. There is a proof for that, but it uses calculus. And I think it's a little bit further along on where you guys are on calculus. So I'm not gonna show that to you guys. All right, so what I wanna do is let's start with the homework for practice A. Finally got smart and copied the page because the book is so huge. All right, my book is bigger than yours, the teacher manual. So here we go, it's on page 263. And I am concerned, did I remember to, yes, I am recording. I had to check, sorry. Out of practice. Okay, so it's on page 263 and it's just problems 8 and 9. That's what we'll do in this video to help prepare you for practice A. All right, so one of the things that I didn't do and I'll be doing that in class is, and I'm gonna ask you guys to do that too, is to grab a key, grab any key and tie a string to it. And I used to do this in the classroom. And you take your key and you have your long string and you're just gonna hold on to the one end of the string and spin it around. Boom, you're gonna make your key go round and round and round and round. Okay, when you let go, and that's what I do, I let go, the direction of the keys, where the keys fly is what I want you guys to notice. And you will notice that it will go tangential to the direction of the circle that you're spinning in. So if you let go at this point, it's gonna go in this direction. If you let go at this point, it's gonna go in this direction. Okay, so that's what this means. A building superintendent twirls a set of keys in a circle at the end of a cord. If the keys have a centripetal acceleration of 145 meters per second squared, and the cord has a length of 0.34 meters, what is the tangential speed? Notice how it says speed. I guess they just want the magnitude, not the direction, instead of tangential velocity. All right, so grab my paper here. We write down what we know. The first thing they tell you is the centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration they give you is 145 meters per second squared. All right, and the next thing it tells you is the length. Well, what does that mean? Okay, so here's my string. There's my little key. Oops, my little key there. There's my string. There's the length, and it's going round and round and round and round and round and round and round, et cetera. Obviously, the length should be the same on both sides if I drew this to scale, right? The radius is the same on both sides. So it says the length. Okay, well, in centripetal motion, we call the distance from here to here the radius. So they gave us the length of the string, but in centripetal motion math, we're going to call that the radius. So we know the radius is 0.34 meters. And it wants to know that tangential speed. Well, I'm going to go ahead and say tangential velocity because that's what my equation is for. And we already discussed that the centripetal acceleration is vt squared over r. Now you're going to start realizing why I've been so serious with you guys on learning how to solve for the variable. You're going to get lots of experience with that this semester. So what I want to do, I want to solve for, looking for my highlighter, I want to solve for vt. Well, this equation isn't vt, it's vt squared. No problem. I'll solve for vt and then I'll square root it. All right, so from here, I'm going to have to multiply r to both sides. Okay, my r's cancel out. So I end up with vt squared is equal to r times centripetal acceleration. Okay, so I got 0.34 meters times 145 meters per second squared. Now, you'll notice your units are always your friend. Here I'm going to end up with meter squared over second squared, huh? Meter squared over second squared. If you do that, that'll be a reminder, oh, that's right, I need to do a square root. All right, so let's do that. Here we go. 0.34 times 145 is equal to 49.3. There we go, 49.3 meters per second squared. All right, so like we said, now we have to take the square root of that. Let's take the square root of that. I'm gonna go second and then the answer. There we go, 7.02 meters per second. So I know exactly that the velocity, that's the velocity squared, vt squared, so therefore this is vt, okay. And it, just a reminder, I had to take the square root of the square vt to get vt. Okay, all right, so that's the first one. Let's read the second one. That was number 8. Okay, the next one, here we go. Number 9, a sock stuck to the side of a clothes dryer. I love that. Happens to me all the time. I lose socks. I don't know where it goes. Because the dryer, your clothes dryer, if you help to do the laundry, is spinning around. So that's an example of circular motion. Okay, here we go. A sock stuck to the side of a clothes dryer barrel has a centripetal acceleration of, here we go, it was centripetal acceleration. If the dryer barrel has a radius of, centimeters, what's the tangential speed? So that's a similar problem, huh? Okay, so let's see. I've got centripetal acceleration is 28 meters per second squared. Here's a good example why writing down the units is a good idea, because I have that the radius is 27 centimeters. Then I realize, my units are not going to cancel out if I don't make them both the same. But I'm going to write the equation first. What is the equation? I have centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration is tangential velocity divided by the radius. Okay, and they're asking for what the tangential speed is. So I really want to know what the tangential velocity is. Okay, except we're not giving the direction. So it's really the speed. Okay, same thing here. So I'm gonna go ahead, just like before, we wanna solve for VT squared. I multiplied R to both sides. So I had VT squared is equal to R times AC. Now you have a choice. You can convert it first or you can convert it here. Really, no matter, as long as it gets done, right? Because you want your units to cancel out. Since this is so just multiplying two numbers, I'm just gonna go ahead and do it right here. All right, so I have my radius as 27 centimeters. And I'm like, oh yeah, but I need it to be meters. Otherwise it's not going to, wait, did I do that right here? VT, yeah. I need to have the meters multiply to be meters squared over seconds squared. So right here, I'm gonna say, okay, I know that there's 100 centimeters to 1 meter. There we go. Now I'm done. I've got that radius here is in meters because my centimeters cancels out. And I multiply it by the acceleration, centripetal acceleration. Make sure you guys practice that word. It takes a little bit to get your tongue back there, centripetal. All right, 28 to a square. So I just have to multiply 27 times 28 and divide it by 100. Let's do that. Okay, 27 times 28. And now I divide it by 100. See, it's better if I turn off the light. There we go. And I get 7.56. So this VT squared is 7.56 meters squared divided by seconds squared. So that's my reminder. I need to square root it. Okay, let's do square root this one right here. Oops, caramba. Sorry. Here we go, this one right here, the answer. Hit the wrong button. Okay, let's try this again. I'm gonna do this again. 27 times 28 divided by 100. All right, let's try this again. Second, there's my square root, and this time I'll hit the answer button. There we go. All righty, so VT is 2.7495 meters per second, and yeah, I would round it off. Round it off there, I don't know how many centimeters. My tendency is to just say 2.75 meters per second. That's good. And there we have it. I'm checking the answers here. This was number 9. Yep, they say 2.7. Notice how, reason why you'll find the solution not necessarily correct, unless I did make a mistake here, 2.7, is because they round off earlier on, and I do not want you guys rounding off early on because you're entering, adding error right from the get-go. All right, so there you have it. And that's it. And the next video, I will be preparing you for practice B. See you next time. All right.